Once we reach the age of 50, maintaining muscle mass becomes a vital yet often neglected aspect of healthy aging. This challenge, which mind you is a natural part of aging, affects not only our physical strength, but also our overall well-being. The gradual decrease in muscle mass, also known as sarcopenia, is more than just an inevitable part of aging. It's a critical factor that impacts our quality of life. Fortunately, there is a little-known secret to combating this decline. Join us as we present the little-known secret to keeping muscle mass after age 50. As we celebrate our 50th birthdays, many of us do so with mixed emotion. We're wiser, more confident, and have achieved various career and life successes. But we also realize our bodies are changing in ways we may not enjoy. Decreased muscle mass, joint discomfort, more tired legs, softer middles. This unavoidable muscle loss that comes with the passing decades can leave us feeling like our best days are behind us, or that our bodies are betraying us. But while some amount of lean tissue loss is expected, the common belief that preserving muscle past 50 is impossible or difficult is false. With knowledge, commitment, and strategic action, we can defy the norm of a steady physical decline. Why is muscle building harder after 50? In our 20s and 30s, we likely took our well-functioning physiology for granted. We could eat poorly, skimp on sleep, skip workouts, and still maintain decent muscle mass, seemingly without effort. But around age 50, changes begin that disrupt this status quo and make building lean tissue more difficult. Hormonal changes. A prominent factor is decreasing levels of key muscle-supporting hormones, chiefly testosterone and growth hormone. Often dubbed fountain of youth hormones, testosterone and HGH promote protein synthesis and energy production while limiting fat gain and inflammation, helping us build lean mass and stay strong. Around 50, however, levels of these hormones start to naturally diminish, accelerating loss of muscle. Low testosterone is also linked to decreases in strength, reduced bone density, and impaired cognitive function. Blunting of signals driving muscle protein synthesis. Research shows that as we age, the pathways directing muscle growth in response to exercise and feeding become less sensitive and responsive. The triggers stimulating muscle to get bigger and stronger after each training session decrease. Scientists believe molecular signals activating muscle-building processes are muted by up to 50% by age 60. This anabolic resistance means seniors must work harder during training to create muscle damage and spur sufficient tissue repair and expansion. Loss of fast-twitch muscle fibers. Studies indicate we lose fast-twitch muscle fibers as we age. These fibers generate powerful, explosive contractions during strength training and high-intensity sprints. Loss of these fibers reduces seniors' potential rate of force development and capacity to sufficiently challenge muscles for growth. Increased inflammation. Low-grade chronic inflammation increases with aging due to higher visceral fat deposition, cell damage from free radicals, and a hyperactive immune system. This inflammation impairs muscle-building processes. Digestive changes. Aging brings changes to digestive function, reduced stomach acid, fewer digestive enzymes produced, etc., that hinder absorption of muscle-supporting protein and nutrients from food. Compromised nutrition makes obtaining building blocks for repair and growth of lean tissue more difficult. Strategies to build muscle after 50. Adopt an anabolic diet. Make protein a priority at every meal, with a focus on high-quality sources like eggs, meat, dairy, and fish. Older adults need a higher dietary protein intake, about 1 to 1.5 grams per kilogram of body weight daily, to maximize muscle protein synthesis in response to training. Time your consumption of protein around workouts to best support repair and growth. Whey protein consumed before or after training robustly activates muscle-building pathways, mTOR and MAPK, due to its high leucine content, making it ideal for older fitness enthusiasts. Casein protein consumed at night also provides a sustained, slow-digesting source of amino acids to aid muscle recovery while sleeping. Additionally, ensure sufficient intake of muscle-supporting nutrients like creatine, carnitine, omega-3s, vitamin D, zinc, magnesium, and chromium picolinate. If diet can't provide optimal amounts, high-quality supplements are recommended. Follow an intense progressive overload program. The primary driver behind muscle hypertrophy at any age is progressive strength training that forces continual tissue adaptation. Execute technically sound compound lifts like squats, deadlifts, and presses using weight loads high enough to induce muscle failure and mechanical damage. Systematically increase demands each session via heavier weights or more repetitions to force muscles to continually adapt and strengthen. Training to failure. Pushing sets to the point where no more repetitions can be completed is crucial for maximizing muscle-building stimulus. Training to momentary muscular failure requires muscles to work harder than during normal day-to-day activities, forcing adaptation. Execute repetitions until muscles reach temporary involuntary exhaustion while maintaining proper form. Preserve fast-twitch fibers. Over 50, intentionally train fast-twitch muscle fibers through brief, high-intensity sessions focused on explosive contractions. Maintain these powerful fibers via plyometrics, sprints, throwing medicine balls, and Olympic lifts completed for low repetitions but high sets. Strategically allow for recovery. Adequate rest is key so muscle tissues can effectively regenerate between workouts. Provide muscles 48 to 72 hours recovery time after intense resistance training sessions targeting the same muscle groups. Prioritize sleep, stress control, myofascial release, contrast showers, massages, and consumption of anti-inflammatory foods. Consider hormone replacement therapy, HRT. Under an anti-aging doctor's supervision, bioidentical testosterone replacement therapy, TRT, and growth hormone can restore lagging hormonal levels to more youthful ranges. Return of anabolic hormones reverses adverse body composition changes, reactivates protein synthesis, reduces inflammation, and rescues waning physical function. It requires closely monitored blood work, but research deems it generally safe for most men over 50. Supplement strength training with cardio. While strength training is the main driver for muscle growth, incorporating cardio offers additional advantages. It stimulates muscle capillarization to improve nutrient delivery and waste removal. It increases appetite-suppressing hormones. It burns calories to support a muscle-building caloric surplus, and it improves insulin sensitivity for more efficient nutrient transport into muscle cells. For optimal results, aim for 2 to 4 moderate intensity cardio sessions per week, lasting 30 to 45 minutes each. Avoid chronic caloric restriction. Aggressively cutting calories to try to get ultra lean works well for younger gym goers, but backfires as muscle-sparing hormones wane. Chronic dietary restrictions sap energy and strength while slowing metabolic rate, promoting muscle loss and rebound weight gain. Now it's time to hear from you. Do these feel like achievable goals for you? Let us know in the comments section below.